Look for the mode for each group of data items if it exists. For the first example here, we are given 7, 4, 12, 8, 5, 1, 3, 4. The mode is defined to be the number which appears most often in a set of numbers. In this given set here, 4 appears twice, while the rest of the numbers only appears once. Therefore, the mode is equal to 4. Number 2, let us consider the group of data here, which consists of 11, 6, 4, 0, 2, 1, 12, 0, 0. Looking at the data entries, the value that appears most frequently is 0. So therefore, the mode here is equal to 0. Again, the mode. Next, we will consider this next set of data. Upon examining the entries, we notice that 1.4 and 9.0 both appear 3 times. This is an example of a bimodal set, which means we have 2 modes in this case, and the modes are equal to 1.4 and 9.0, since both numbers appear thrice. Then lastly, let's consider this next set of data entries. We have 1, 3, 5, 10, 8, 6, and 7. Notice that all numbers here appear once, so therefore, this is an example of a set that has no mode. For the next set of exercises, we are going to find for the midrange. When we say midrange, that is the central point of the possible values for the data items. And that is computed by getting the average of the smallest and the largest value in the data set. So in this case here, for number 1, to get the midrange, we are going to add the smallest, which is 1, to the largest, which is 12, and then divide the sum by 2. And this is equal to 13 divided by 2, and that is equal to 6.5. All right, number 2, let's compute for the midrange. To compute for the midrange, let us first identify the lowest data value. The lowest data value in this case is 0, and add that to the highest data value, which in this case is equal to 12, and divide that by 2, divide the sum by 2. So 0 plus 12 is 12, divided by 2 is equal to 6. For this next set of data entries, let's compute for the midrange. So first, let us identify the lowest data value. The lowest data value is 1.4, and then add that to the highest data value, which in this case is equal to 9.0, and divide the sum by 2. And 1.4 plus 9.0 divided by 2 is equal to 5.2. So the midrange for this data set is equal to 5.2. So for this next exercise, we are given a frequency distribution table, and we are asked to find the midrange for the data items. The midrange is computed by getting the average of the lowest data value and the highest data value. The frequency does not affect the midrange. So to get the midrange in this case, we are just going to add the lowest data value, which is 1, and then add that to the highest data value, which is 10, divided by 2. We have 11 divided by 2, and that is equal to 5.5. Next, let us consider the table here that shows the net worth for the first 13 U.S. presidents, and then find the mean, median, mode, and the mid-range for the following data items. First, let's compute for the mean. So to compute for the mean, we just need to sum up the column here for the net worth of the presidents expressed in millions of dollars, and then divide that by the total number of presidents. So the mean is equal to the summation of x divided by m. The sum for this column is equal to 1,243. So therefore, 1,243 divided by 13 is equal to 95.6. So the mean is $95.6 million. Next, we will compute for the median. To compute for the median, the data must be put in order. So we will arrange it from smallest to largest. We have 4, 6, 7, 11, 21, 21, 29, 30, 57, 112, 131, 234, and 580. Now, since we have 13 data entries here, and that is an odd number, therefore the median is the middle term. To locate for the middle term, we can use the position formula. 13 plus 1 divided by 2, that is equal to 14 over 2, and that is 7. That means the seventh position is the median in this case. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is the seventh position, and that is the median for this set here. That is equal to 29. Next, let us identify the mode. Now, by looking at the data entries here, all data entries are unique. Therefore, there is no mode in this data set. For the midrange, we just need to get the average of the lowest data value and the highest data value. So the midrange is equal to 4 plus 580 divided by 2. And that is equal to 292 million. Now let's consider this problem here. An advertisement for a speed reading course claimed that the average reading speed for people completing the course was 1,000 words per minute. Shown below are the actual data for the reading speeds per minute for a sample of 24 people who completed a course. Find the mean, median, mode, and midrange. Then answer the question, which measure of central tendency was given in the advertisement? Before we compute for the mean, median, mode, and midrange, let us first organize the data entries into a table. We will arrange the data entries from the smallest value to the largest value, which is 1,100. So we have 600, and 600 appears once, and then 650 appears twice, 700 appears twice, 750 appears twice, 800 thrice, 850 three times, 900 three times, 950 two times, 1,000 four times, 1,050 once, and 1,100 once, for a total of 24 people. To compute for the mean, we will just multiply these values here on this column to the values on this column here pointwise, and then add the product and divide that by 24. Adding everything, divide up by 24, we get 854 words per minute. Next, let us compute for the median. Now notice that we have 24 people or 24 data entries here, and that is even number. To compute for the median, we will have to identify the middle terms, the two middle terms, and get the average of the two middle terms. If we're going to use the position formula, we have 24 plus 1 divided by 2, that is equal to 25 divided by 2, which is 12.5. The two middle terms will be the 12th and the 13th position. To determine the 12th and the 13th data entry, we will just count down from the number of people here. So we have 1 plus 2, that is equal to 3, plus 2, that's 5, plus 2, 7, plus 3, 10, and then plus 3, that gives us 13. So therefore, the 12th and the 13th data entry are both equal to 850. Get the average, so 850 plus 850 divided by 2 is equal to 850 words per minute. Next, let's identify the mode. The mode is the value that appears most frequently. So we will just refer to this column here and identify the value that appears most frequently. The value that appears most frequently is equal to 1,000. 1,000 appears 4 times. So therefore, the mode is 1,000 words per minute. For the mid-range is the average of the lowest data entry and the highest data entry. Now, the lowest data entry here is 600, and the highest data entry is 1,100. The average of the two is equal to 850 words per minute. Now, going back to the second question, which measure of central tendency was given in the advertisement? Now, based on our computation, the 1,000 words per minute is not actually the mean or the average, but rather it is the mode for the data set. So therefore, the measure of central tendency that was given in the advertisement was the mode.